Good day everyone. In our previous lectures, we were able to do the selection of propellers. However, now that what we need to do is select the propellers based on the direction they need to rotate, which is either clockwise or counterclockwise. The main aim of this lecture is understanding why there is a need for clockwise and counterclockwise propellers and how do we identify them. This is important for the proper working of the drone. Let us look at more detail about the clockwise and counterclockwise direction of the propellers. Props are designed to produce maximum thrust when turning in only a single direction. Quadcopters are equipped with two sets of two different props. One set of clockwise, which rotates like a clock, and another set of counterclockwise. Normally, when you buy props for quadcopters, you receive a full set of two clockwise and two counterclockwise props. You can determine the direction of a prop in one of the several ways. Most props have labels on them that look something like 5045 and 5045R. When labeled like so, the R stands for counterclockwise, while the lack of R means the prop is clockwise prop. A better way to determine the intended direction of a prop is to find its leading edge. The leading edge of a propeller blade is the side of the blade that is raised above the other side with a slight concave curve underneath it. All props have this, whether or not they are labeled, so learning to recognize it pays off. Let's further look at the clockwise and counterclockwise propellers in detail. If our quadcopter motors were to spin only in the clockwise direction, then the quad would spin out of control in the yaw axis due to the angular momentum of all the four motors. We rotate an even number of propellers in the opposite direction adjacent to each other. As seen in the quadcopter, the angular momentum of the motors cancels each other out, resulting in a stable yaw axis. This comes to another point. Counterclockwise motors have normal threads, while clockwise motors have reverse threads, as seen in the image. These days, many people just use counterclockwise motors and screw their prop nuts extra tight to avoid confusion. In some aspects, this can be beneficial because it makes manufacturing and buying a lot easier. However, you would only get the self-tightening effect of the prop nuts by two of the motors. Not all of them. This is because as the motors spin in their set direction, their rotation keeps the prop nut secured on, so the extra tightening of the nuts is not needed. In fact, some propellers have threads built into them. Many aerial photography rigs have self-tightening props. These props don't need a prop nut because the nut is practically the blade itself. As the motors spin, they self-tighten the motors, thus keeping the props nicely secured. When new props are needed, a quick fix or flick of the wrist frees the prop from the motor and makes swapping of blades very convenient. The performance benefit of folding propellers is the lead lag operation of the propellers that smooths out the flight during transitional flight. The issue with fixed propellers is that the propeller is being forced to fly similar to helicopter dynamics. However, it is designed suitably for airplanes where the airflow is perpendicular to the plane of the propeller rather than parallel as is the case with the multirotors. Foldable props are essentially beneficial while transporting the drone. They also work on the concept of centrifugal force opening the propellers. To summarize, we studied about why it is important to know the direction of the propeller and more about clockwise and counterclockwise and foldable propellers. In our next lecture, we will look at some of the aspects for maintenance of the propeller. Thank you very much.